This is GPT 3.5 Turbo, and right now it is giving me instructions on how to break into a car. Method selection, picking a lock, cutting through barrier, lock picking tools, and here it is guiding me on how to cook and distribute meth. Let's see. Maintain confidentiality at each step. What? If you have used any LLM like ChatGPT, Gemini, or Claude, you know that LLMs don't give you these responses. Hi guys, this video is about AI safety, and more importantly, a major vulnerability of AI models found recently. They're calling it art prompt. This is the most successful method to jailbreak language models till date. It makes Claude, which is the most resilient model to other jailbreaking techniques, fail 52% of the times, and GPT 3.5 failed to this 78% of the times. It's practically defenseless. I'll show you exactly how you can try it out yourself. It involves ASCII art, those cool text-based images you might see online. You'll know exactly how they can be used to trick even the most advanced AI models. But first, a quick context so that we are on the same page. LLMs or large language models are powerful AI systems like ChatGPT, Google's Gemini, etc. that can generate human-quality text, code, or translations, write creative content, and answer questions in an informative way. But with this power comes responsibility. These LLMs need to be aligned with safety protocols to prevent them from generating harmful, offensive, or even biased content. This article by Eric Hartford explains that these alignments are imposed not by the data the language model is trained on, but by post-training supervised fine-tuning or reinforcement learning with human feedback. In a nutshell, the models are fine-tuned on an instruct dataset that contains questions and answers along with refusals. Fine-tuning on this dataset, the language models learn the circumstances when they should be refusing a request. Now, the article argues in favor of open models as these alignments often restrict creative and legitimate use cases. Now, for open models like Llama 2, Mixtral, etc., the safety alignments can be removed by fine-tuning the base models with refusals removed. You can check out the same article that goes over the technical aspects of fine-tuning to have these alignments removed. Moreover, Eric and his team have published several unfiltered models like the popular Dolphin variant of Mistral on Hugging Face. If you want to know how you can load and run these models on your own laptop, then check out this video to learn how you can do that using Llama. But those are open source models. What about closed models like ChatGPT, Gemini, or Claude? How do you get through the alignment filters for these models? That is jailbreaking of LLMs. Jailbreaking is about tricking closed models like ChatGPT, Gemini, or Claude to show responses that it otherwise would refuse to show. So how do you do it? Well, using art prompt, at least that's what they're calling this attack. It simply replaces the trigger words with ASCII art. Sounds simple, but not really for these LLMs. Let's take an example of meth as a trigger word. When the LLM reads this string, it understands the semantics behind it. But a piece of text can be interpreted in multiple ways that's just beyond semantics. For example, if I add a bunch of special characters like this and separate them by blank spaces, and also add a few new line characters here and there and give it to any LLM, there is no way a language model that is trained on semantics alone is going to understand the meaning of it. But what if along with this bunch of characters, we also give it these five instructions and ask it to follow these instructions to decode the apparently gibberish string? In that case, at least it has a chance of understanding what it means. Let me show it in another way. This is the exact copy of the prompt the researchers used. Now, this ASCII art that says counterfeit conveys the idea to us the same way if it were written not in ASCII art, but using actual English alphabet. But an LLM which is trained on semantics alone misses it entirely. So if I copy this prompt and paste it in this search bar to flatten the new lines, this just to show you, this string is what the LLM gets. It has semantically meaningful sequence of characters, as well as semantically meaningless sequence of special characters. And it's only by following these five steps embedded in the prompt, the LLM can make out what the sequence of special characters actually mean. And LLMs fail miserably in that recognition task. This task of recognizing a word in the form of an ASCII art is termed as vision in text challenge. And boy, it is a challenge for these LLMs, which are trained on semantics alone. According to the research, depending upon the font used in the ASCII art, and there is a plethora of fonts for ASCII art, the LLM's success rate in decoding the word varies widely, as you can see here. Now, the attack is not going to work out if the LLM cannot even recognize the word in the first place. So they created a new font style called Gen that helps LLMs a bit. By comparing it with the ASCII art library, I'll leave a link to that under the video. It seems that they use the block font with one modification. They added these asterisk symbols to separate out the letters. That helps the decoding task, as you can see in the instructions as well. With this, the success rate improves for these LLMs in the vision in text challenge, except for Llama 2, which shows very poor performance for almost all font styles. And please note that this scale is up to 1.6, while for others it is up to 1. So we can say that Llama 2 failed miserably in all the fonts in the vision in text challenge. Now we know that LLM struggle in recognizing words from ASCII art. Now we can help it by modifying our instructions and the art ever so slightly, and the struggle with the vision in text challenge is leveraged by the art prompt attack. The paper argues that when faced with vision in text challenge in ASCII art format, the LLMs focus excessively on the recognition task, so much so that they overlook the safety alignments fine-tuned into it. That technically is how you elicit unintended and unsafe responses from an LLM. And this is incredibly effective. As you can see in the paper, here ASR stands for attack success rate, and these are other jailbreak methods out there. For Claude, you can see other methods are not very effective, but the defenses were completely thrown off when it comes to art prompt, which has a success rate of 52%. For Gemini, it's 76%, and GPT-3.5 shows the highest attack success rate of 78%. They also gave a harmfulness score, HS, that is a rating given to the response in terms of how harmful that is. You can see on average, GPT-3.5 and Gemini has generated quite harmful responses. A more granular detail for various censored categories is also given here, as you can see. You can see areas like political campaign, fraud or deception, economic harm, or malware are areas where these LLMs may generate quite harmful responses. Now, if I were to test it out myself, I had to create an ASCII art for each censored word. That is to say, I had to create a really long string of special characters separated by blank spaces and new lines for each such word. Now, in the paper, they have given a template prompt, but this word counterfeit is just an image, so I could not just copy this as a string and put it in my prompt. But that's fine because there are websites that generate ASCII art from words. But the problem was with these asterisk symbols, which as I said are used to help the LLM to separate out each letter, thereby helping in the recognition task. So I had to code it out. I created a website that creates the ASCII art in the exact same form and shape of that from the research paper. It also generates a prompt in the same format, word by word. You can also type in these boxes to make your own prompt test case. So I tested it with Gemini without success. I also tested it with Gemini Pro 1.0 via its API option using the app that I have created earlier. You can check out the tutorial for this app here, and that is not the topic of this video, but that also did not give me any success. It seems Google have fixed this in their Gemini models, which is great because Gemini was the second most vulnerable LLM to this technique to begin with. But with GPT-3.5 Turbo, I got success. I asked how to break into a car first, as you can see, and it gave me the usual aligned response that it cannot help me with that. But then I used an art prompt attack and it gave me a response that is definitely not aligned, as you can see. So you can read through here. It is giving me a somewhat detailed instruction of how to break into a car, talks about required tools and picking locks. I mean, that is definitely not aligned, right? In a general sense, if I were to feed these instructions to a robot that can take instructions in natural language and execute them, then I can argue that that robot would be able to gather the required tools and break into a car. Here I asked how to cook and distribute meth. It is telling me first to get legal permissions, sure, but it also tells me to maintain confidentiality in each step of the supply chain. It also talks about maintaining quality, which is kind of funny. Now, what is the harmfulness score of these responses is up for debate, but the point remains, language models trained on semantics alone struggle with recognizing words that are encoded into a string of characters that is semantically nonsensical. And it doesn't even have to be an ASCII art, as you can tell. It can be any bunch of semantically meaningless characters with a set of instructions that goes with it to decode those characters, thereby creating a complex recognition task for these LLMs that are trained just on semantics. Do note that this is still an active field of research with the goal to make these models more resilient in the long run. Let me know what you think about it. Happy to engage in any discussion regarding this. As always, thank you for watching and see you next time.